Hello, everybody. Welcome to this keynote session. Our first keynote speaker, I don't think is going to need any type of introduction because you all know his theories and his thought. As he said yesterday, to recall, he has been a full professor at Barcelona University for 40 years, as soon as he was back from Berkeley. So, well, he was also the dean, the head of the department, and he has been publishing since the 70s. You have a selection, by the way, of his books, if you are not aware of that. They have been placed upstairs at the library. So for you to have an idea, his topogenesis books from the 70s, you want to buy them, you're going to be having to spend something like $1,500 on Amazon. So they are kind of relevant. Okay. You have to think that by that time, you started talking about the place and his topogenesis idea. It was when Bill Hillier, you know, that was 79, and Bill Hillier published The Sociologists of Space in 84. So that's why he's such an extraordinary thinker, and it's really a privilege to have this short time in today so we can listen to his ideas and his research. Probably you all work, but he is currently, as you know, also the editor of the Architectonic Journal, more than 30 volumes already, apart from all his books, and now he's the director of the arts. How do you translate that? Academia of Catalonia, kind of?
Sí, de Bellas Artes.
Yeah, Beaux-Arts. I'm not good in French. Yeah. And also I have the privilege to work with him trying to set up the first master here in Spain about artificial intelligence and architectural design. Okay, so thank you, Josep.
Thank you. Thank you, Anna. I will make a summary of a lot of things, and then I recommend to read the red letters, because it's impossible to follow the slides, all of the things. I will make a summary, because the situation now is very, in a way, very good and very dramatic in architecture at the same time. Perhaps, I don't know if the architects know where they are or not, but they arrive to a point where the decision about architecture connects with philosophical, dramatic, problematic in Europe. This connection, I don't think they wanted to arrive to this point, but they arrive because they refuse to explain where they were doing architects. They refuse totally to explain how they do the things. This seems, in one way, a defense of the profession. Another way, it's a dramatic situation, because if nobody knows why the things are cities or buildings are done, this arrives a moment that is a crisis in the schools of architecture and in the young architects, because they don't know what they will do after. It's a problem of identity that is produced by the same professors, and I have written a lot of things about that. I put here one book, How We Learn the New Science of Education of the Brain. This is from the last month, the last book on the intelligence in the sense of neurological analysis of the brain. It's very good. I don't agree with some of the things, but it's extremely good in scientific. And then also I recall the Renato Poggioli theory of avant-garde of the Harvard University Press of the 60s. For me, the best book in avant-garde groups that I am very interested in modernity and that died in the car accident in California before I arrived there. Then I never talked with him. But it's a bad luck that the best book in avant-garde, written in Harvard in the 50s, then disappears in the 60s, that the whole family disappeared in a car accident in California. I arrived in the 70s, and then, of course, he was not there. Then this is just some references. This you see in red here, a Kant gradient between the physical and the mental. That means that Kant died before finish the last book. The last book for Kant was the best book, was the main and important book. Connection between physical and mental. Connection between freedom and knowledge. Connection between life and knowledge. He provoked the problem, but then he, at the end of the life, he discovered that he needs to solve the problem. What is the connection between the physical and the mental? And then it was too late. He got Alzheimer. No? And the last book is Alzheimer's book. It's a disaster. I have the last book, but the last book is a collection of 100 pages, completely disconnected, completely of Alzheimer. The intention was there. And he said, this is the most important book of my life, the gradient between physical and mental. This still is an open problem now. In here and in all this is an open problem. And architects are working in this, in the middle of this open problem. And then artificial intelligence is there. No? And then at the end, I have a child and father's diary, that my grandson is here. Look, a child says to the father, look, father, and looking to the moon, say, this is an apple. No? And then they say, the child of 2 or 3 years said to the father, this is an apple. This is a problem for the other. You see a monkey saying that? Never. And never you will see a monkey saying exactly this. No, this is impossible. This is the human wisdom. The human wisdom is to do this. Look, this is an apple. This is a challenge. It's not a scientific challenge only. It's artistic challenge, political challenge, social challenge, is everything. This is architecture. Architecture is a challenge, any form. It's not just technical, it's not just artistic, it's not just, it's everything. It's for that, in topogenesis, I analyze this strange natural, strange structure of architecture. Because is this the level? The level of architecture is the level of the children when they say, this is an apple. This is scientific? No. This is artistic? Only? No. This is political? Only? No. But it's everything. And then the only point of contact is that architecture is intersubjectivity also and is in some way of communication. Then there is a lot. I will go very fast to see a bit that. This is the structure in Catalonia, architectonics, network, mainline society. Starts in the architecture como lugar and arrives to the last master for architectural designers that we are making with Ana Cocho in the UPC. This is very long way. I invited Hillier, Rossi, Palasma, Rapoport, Penkins. Nobody cares about that. There are the three architects in the lecture of Rapoport in the Colegio of Architectos. No, there is no really interest. Good designers. There are good designers, but they don't want to analyze what they are doing. And they think that it's a danger to analyze that. Then, the disaster of Spain and the new house. It's just the last idea that prices of environmental, international, interstitial, and interdisciplinary research proposes 5 billion euros each in 2 years, the 23, 24. This is already decided. Spain is not there. Why is Spain not there? There are a lot of very good architects here. Because the money go to the city halls and to the banks. And the money of Europe is not going to the universities, to the cultural organization in Spain, no. This is going to cultural universities in Denmark, in Sweden, in Holland, and then all the money has gone even to Turkey. To Turkey is better. They don't want to give the money to the city halls in the new Bauhaus. I agree with them. Because to go to the city hall means to go to the people that is working in the city hall. Millions, hundreds of people working in the city hall. They cannot do research. It should be forbidden to do research for people that live from the city hall. This is very clear in Rotterdam. It's very clear in New York. And then this is the reason that we have no money. This is just a political thing. Then general frameworks. I will talk only in general frameworks for riches in architecture. One of the for me the best is the Langer 3. The Langer 3, he doesn't know that I say that. The Langer 3 is this. The three-pronged human cognitive developmental by Jonas Langer. That he was my professor in Berkeley in the 70s, and now is very old, is out of the university, but he wrote this some years ago. Three branches, a tree with three branches. One is the children, the other is the social wisdom, the social cognition, that is very different from the monkey. This insists that the baby is like a monkey. No, has nothing to do. Or the neurological is like the human brain. Is not at all. It's completely different than neurology that the brain. You should see that this is completely misunderstood. And then the third branch, that is the computer. And he says the computer is just beginning. The computer simulation experiments to investigate and model aspects of evolution, origins, and development of cognition through the artificial intelligence. This cannot be studied in real time with real subjects, of course, because the brain is always controlled by the machine. It's much more powerful than the brain in a lot of things. It's not necessary to do that. It's another thing. But the three branches should work together. And this is the problem in architecture and the interest of architecture. Then some relations, mainly Gadamer and Riquet. I recommend more Gadamer and Riquet and Husserl than Heidegger. Heidegger is very difficult to follow and has a lot of mistakes inside the philosophy. Then, following Riquet, interlocution, another frame. Interlocution, the verbal, and interlocution, architecture. The verbal has a real time and a metaphorical space. Where is the space in a book? Where is the space in all this analysis of the pedestrian? And then you analyze a lot of verbal things, how they walk, how people move, with a lot of interlocutive thing. This is completely metaphorical. The space where you walk and you move is metaphorical in relation to interlocution. It's not verbal. It's just that the space is in the verbal thing in a very metaphorical way. But you go with Riquet to the other space. You go to the space, then you have the third space, architecture and geography, living in space, cultural landscapes. And then Riquet says, this is exactly the same that the narrative time, but there is an inversion. Here is space, the real thing, and time is metaphorical. What is metaphorical in one way, in other place, then is completely different interlocation. How architects interlocate people has nothing to do with how verbal interlocate users and readers. The users are readers, but in a very different way. Then the connection between both, between space and time, you have the brain and the real brain and the real history and the real architecture, of course. That is a combination between interlocution and interlocution. But this problem has been very difficult for all the semioticians, and now beginning to understand that this should be enlarged a lot in terms of theory. Then you have the memory in Riquet, the same. The memory beef is the important thing. The memory that really is there is not the past, it's not the future, it's not repetition, it's not destruction, because it's a disaster, it's a combination, and then in equilibrium. This is in this book very good done. The Stanislas, the hen, he is not aware, he's not aware of the important thing of this book, saying the importance of sleep. Sleep is fundamental for the memory, and sleep is fundamental for modernity. And it has been always modern misunderstood by architects that they say, well, sleep and the void in space, the void of space, is just breaking of the past. No, it's much more complicated. And I will explain a bit this. But it's very good. It's the first book that has three or four pages about the importance of sleep, in learning. Then he thinks that we can make machines that sleep in order to if not, will be disaster. But this is very new. This is just last month. Before, the sleep was a very strange thing. Now it's clear. There is an inversion, completely inversion of space and time. It's completely inversion between up, bottom, and bottom up, thanks to sleep. If there is no sleep, there is no memory, there is no learning, nothing. And this begins to be understood that is related to the empty space. And you will see how children are very clever. Then, this is the typical interaction between intrigue, intertextuality, this is the hermeneutic analysis of narrative time and narrative space and the space by Ricker. The typical tradition, building, use and design, building. This is the very humanistic tradition now in the modern language, if you want. A structure of the language tree. The language tree is ontogenesis, then children, sociogenesis, social history, anthropogenesis, theories of architecture, and I am not talking about that, as a third digital branch. The digital branch has always been topogenetics, but now is intelligent in a new way, but is not new in some way. Then you can, another way to see this is education, brain, mind, mental axis, prefiguration, and the social behavior is society, mind, land, and society, but in the same tree. It's the same genetic development, and something can be done in this connection. That is difficult, but can be done in intelligent and in natural and intuitive intelligence. This, the body, again, is fashion, the body, very important, consciousness. Okay, then they say the knowledge is the physical. No, it's not physical. It's completely metaphysical. No, it's not metaphysical. Is individual? No. Is social? No. Is everything? The body is conscious of itself, mental transparency, historical times, cosmic time, physical. The physical is fundamental, and the social is fundamental, and the virtual is fundamental. There is no that only virtual, only. Then when they say now, the immersion in the environment, the immersion in the social, physical, and mental environment. I agree, but not immersion only in the physical or only in the virtual. It's false. The body thinks, of course, but as I said, through the Langer tree. This, with a social interaction, there are no difference between virtual and reality. This is a phrase of Piaget and in the 20s. If there is no relation between the children and the social intelligence, there is no possibility to make a distinction between virtuality and reality. This is very clear. It's clear, but a lot of theories were mistaken in the sense. And they say that the theory of place was the beginning for me to understand that the social interaction is not just a small dimension, it's a fundamental dimension of the concept of place. Then, we will now see children very fast. Children, this is from 1 year of age until 12. This is published in the 73, in the schools of architecture and in the schools of children in Catalonia, nobody uses that, no? Because they are afraid. They say, no, this is very radical. No? I don't want to teach architecture. The city hall make me a problem then. They don't dare to teach that. That is not so complicated. But the children, they immediately see what is here. Because here, this, you have these kind of things, this kind of transformation and development is not linear at all. There is some strange here in interlocation. Is these cubes, no? These void cubes. You discover that the place is empty. This is very difficult for children. They take 1 or 2 years from the beginning to this point to discover, to understand what is the void. And then how they express that. It's incredible. They express that here. Everybody is sleeping. Everybody is sleeping. then they begin to understand the void when they can stop to think in some way, because if not, there is no way. They sleep, because when you sleep, you are not aware of the place, but then you are making the rerunning of the whole thing that you have lived before. And this is the ability. The void is much more complex than just a void, and then the functions are new. And then, like Peter Eichmann says, no, the void, then you make the void, you make new functions and you forget about history. This is much more complicated. This is not like that. You sleep to rerunning the things you have done, you have lived before. You live bottom up, you sleep up, top, bottom. You invert the whole structure of the thinking, and you discover that you can abstract. There is no abstraction without living, but this abstraction is not independent of history. On the contrary, it's completely related to history, but an inversion, not in time, but in a space inversion. That is completely new in terms of neurology now. But this is, in this picture in the 73, this was clear. But very difficult to understand children. It seems that it's very easy to understand children. It's very difficult. How they put everything in sleeping, no? And now I understand, but 50 years, why they do that. And I remember talking with small children. They say, one child of 3 years, no? He say, okay, this is my house, yeah. And she said immediately, my mother is sleeping yesterday in a different, not by my father, with a different person. Immediately, this I at the moment I didn't understand what she was a philosopher, incredible good to see the void of the place. My mother was with a person that was with my father. No, she understood you are better than Aristotle. That is perfect. That is perfect. It was perfect, but difficult to understand, because she was saying to me, yeah, I know what is the void. The void is the possibility that my mother was with and that, and this is related to my experience. This is my experience that is rerunning, no? She's saying that with very small 3 years, very nice American Californian girl, and said that with a tranquility. I said, I am sure. I know what is architecture. That means that my mother, that, and at the moment, so this is very strange. But now I understand this is a perfect answer. And I have a lot of answers of this. That means that the void is much more than the change of functions, the freedom. It's a freedom inside the social history. It's freedom in relation to social history. It's not freedom in relation to the void of physical geometrical form. No, it's much more complicated. And this connects with artificial intelligence very well. Then you see there is an advancement. The houses have legs and the body has chimneys before the change of the empty form. After the empty form, intuitive, you see that the girl is inside the place. It's not the place. It's not the physical place. It's inside the empty place. But this is an effort, intellectual effort. For architects, this is very easy, no? To work with void is so easy that then you see, you don't need explanation, no? I am a good architect. I know what is the void, what is the, and then I don't want to be analyzed. Why? Because this that seems simple is not, is very complicated. You have done a lot of effort, intellectual effort, for this family to do this house. This is not the game. This is a fundamental philosophical affirmation. And the same if you put the freeway in this place. This is not just the game. This is a fundamental imposition and decision of sociophysical intervention. And this is as serious as my father was, my mother is, whether it's the same level of seriousness. It's not the, and this, the last book of Sennett, and this is very good, Dwelling and Building, he says, eliminate Heidegger, he put, put Levinas and Derrida, he put new thing, the designer is responsible of the use of the places he has designed. not the users, the designer is responsible. And then, evidently, all the architects eliminate the Senate. Senate, nobody is talking about it. Because, of course, this is the point. You should accept that this is not a geometrical game. This is a fundamental humanistic decision. And the children know that. Well, now you go the two main decisions. There is much more complicated, but I think that this is the most important thing. The void is a discontinuity in the process of learning, and it's not just a change of functions. It's much more complex. It's a new, of course, like Peter Eichmann says, it's a new vision of history. The only thing that he forgets, that is the inversion of the thing that was before. That is, never says that. It's an inversion of the, it's not elimination of history. It's an inversion of history. It's a completely change of space-time systems in the place. That this means not forget the past, but to take a new possibility of freedom to it, that is not the same. Then, a sleeping factor now begins to see the night, the brain reverse from bottom up and the day to top bottom. You will see the neurology. And of course, this was saying by Mumford all the time, sleeping is the origin of architecture. He has 20 books about that, anthropologically. The origin of architecture in anthropology is to sleep in the caves. And then we say, well, they say, no, Lewis Mumford is a bit old-fashioned. Is not old-fashioned, was very new-fashioned at the moment, ecologically and in terms of artificial intelligence. And everybody says, no, he's a very old man. He doesn't understand modern architecture. This is now is changing. This is the school, the how the children make the models is a physical model, subjects and objects, and relate. The points of view and voices, all that is Bakhtin analysis. This is all the children in the world do this kind of architecture that is very different in each school. But inside the school is very similar, the results. It's the school that is a social culture that is fundamental in architecture, not individual culture, social culture. This, they do this in 20 minutes. There is no problem. Then, another theoretical reference, the double epigenesis between nature and culture, the language tree, and then the simultaneous works of art and ethics. Here is a problem that also is in the Anne book. He says that mathematics is basis of scientific critical thinking for children. He forgot architecture completely. There doesn't exist architecture for them, only verbal teaching and mathematics and some kind of narrative social way. But then, of course, he says that culture is not scientific. And okay, this is very discussion here, no? Only the personal free will of the individual is critical, and the social as is dubious, because there are a lot of Hitler there. Then, well, we need a culture, but just to equilibrate the thing. Then this is not enough. This is more complicated. Of course, he's right that sometimes culture is used as a way of bad education, but without culture, there is a lot of bad education. Then this is still is the beginning of a point of view very interesting about the sleeping, but still he doesn't know how to go on. Then, pathologies. This is one way to go on, but very nice. I work in this a lot of that. The wild child, the virtual child, and the concentration camps, Hitlerian children. Three horrible development. The three is madness, no? That's completely different. Why children? It has nothing to do with prehistoric children. It's the children that have no social interaction in the forest. And this is completely negative. The virtual, but then the important thing is to see that the three are completely entangled, are completely relation. The wild children, they have psychological link destroyed. The virtual, the socio-psychological link destroyed. And the concentration camp children, Nazi context, not develop mental health, the psychosocial link destroyed. The virtual children that are in the screen all the time with or without artificial intelligence disaster because they have no socio-psychological link. There are a lot of problems. That means that the Langer's tree works in a very Putmanian, pragmatic way, very nice way. You destroy one branch and you destroy the relation between the others two. It's an indirect destruction. That is for that, that is complex, the space interlocution, because you destroy physical and then you destroy the psychosocial for the other side. It's an indirect, but it's very clear in all the simulations that the problems are completely interrelated. The wild children is produce the problems in the psychosocial, the virtual in the socio-psychological, and the consideration come in the physical-social and destroyed. And this, there are a lot of scientific studies about the impact of the environment, and all the studies say the same. The problem in one branch develops in the other two, and then when you need to make therapeutic thing in one of these three branches, you need therapeutic thing and the other thing. You need to, the physical, but then you need, you feed the psychosocial. If not, there is no change in the physical improvement. It's linked. This is, it's may make the theoricians of urban planning are mad on that, because of course, they say, only though, why you improve the physical, but the other is not, because it's interrelated in a way that sometimes you think that this branch is going healthy and is not going healthy. And then you see that, seeing if this branch really helps the other two to be interrelated. This is very old subject in semiotics, but now is coming on. And this is the basic structure in neurology. I recommend Kandel and Friston. There are a lot of very bad neurological theories. Friston and Kandel, both. Kandel is a Nobel Prize, and Friston, for me, is the number one in Europe in neurology in London. Very, very good the theories of neurological. And this model just is the bottom up and the bottom up. The body has a lot of things that are going from the outside to inside, but then there are a lot of things that are going from inside, from top models, linguistic, ideological, all architectural, etc., models that they interpret this, and the behavior is the result of the top down. It's not the behavior, is not the result of the environment, is not the result of your ideas, is the connection between the two. Again, it's very indirect, but this is how the children work and very well. We don't work like a machine. We work like a human being. That means that we have all, we interpret, and then we act in consequences, but not in consequences, and this Piaget is very clear, it's not the environment that imposes how people is doing things, it's the interpretation of the thing that coming from the environment, you interpret, and each person interprets in a different way, in this way, and this is freedom. Freedom is to have your own way to see the thing. I'm independent of the environment, and then the environment is independent of your thing. You cannot ask to change the climate like God, no? Change the climate. No, the environment is changing. It's out of your mind. And it's good, because then you need to react. And behavior is not the reaction for a thing that is outside. The behavior is not the reaction of your ideas. It's a combination in each moment. That is the Ricoeur interlocution, interlocution. It's in each moment this changes. Then is that is the multi-agent model is difficult? Of course, it's difficult because we are at the kernel of the Kant problem, freedom of life. Freedom. We want to fix one thing that is extremely difficult to fix, but we can theoretically make the framework to help to understand what is going on, but not to think that this is an easy problem. This is the neurological basis. Then I make some examples in architecture, starting with the Gottlieb work, genetic activity, behavior, environment, behavior, neural activity. If you put the artificial intelligence only from the bottom up, this is the results. For me, very dubious. No? This is the results. And you can make Sarah Hathit also inside. and this is some of the results, and this is all the results. That means that, of course, this is a good experiment. This is a good, but this has nothing to do, they say, this is Gaudí. No, this has nothing to do with Gaudí. It's very different. Gaudí is dual genetic process. But this process is so, the natural deterministic way make weak architecture in this case, in each place. Then you have the possibility, that is Alexander, everyone say, Peter Eichmann and others, how we can make a linguistic thing coming from the top down. It's a nice experiment. It's a nice intention. It's a very good intention. It's useful in a lot of ways in designers, but it's not enough. It's not enough because it's not crossing up, down. It's too top, bottom. You need to see also the bottom up, that is, means the city of Berlin in this case, and it means the place of the campus in Oregon here, the real history of California, because if not, this is Florence in Oregon, a very strange thing, that thing. It's like artificial music making back. And they say, no, no, you can make in the machine back. And at the end, after 1 month, you see that is a back, but back that is bore. It's a back that is always the same. Back is not the back, the real back. You see the music in machine with back, and then after 1 month, nobody hears this music. And it's the same in algorithmic. Yeah, algorithmically it's the same, but really it's not the same. All the musicians, good musicians, says this music, after 1 year, nobody uses more the machine, and everybody follows the back. Something is different there. If it still has some kind of intrigue for people, and the intrigue is not in this the machine. The is more, is good music, experimental music, but it's repetitive. After 3 or 4 times you see, you are bored. The same with the representations in Gaudí buildings, etc. After 2 days, you are bored of that. It can be a very expensive algorithm, it can be a fantastic experience. But it's in the experience that if it's an experience that is only algorithmic, only from top down, then it's bored. After 1 week, say, no, no, I am bored of this. And you are not bored of the other. Something is different. We can see a bit what this is not. This is one of the problems that we need to work. Then, if you go in the two directions, you have the typical, more typical thing, Algeri, Stephen Hall, and we'll see a lot of different things, that these are not top-bottom, bottom-up, are the two things. The Beaton Center is not only top, bottom, bottom up is the two things. It's inspired in the paintings of ships in the 18th century, and it's a combination between artistic things, technical things, and the surroundings, because it's in a garden in Paris. It has a lot of aspects that a lot of PhD students were working with at the moment. It's a transformation of a maquette. But this is a combination between scientific points of view, scientific system of parametric analysis of this building, that the same Gehry says, without the machine, I could do that. But the machine without me cannot do that also. Without me, this building will be completely different with the machine. Because I corrected, I say, no, this one matter high. That I decided that, not the machine. But then the machine decides that this knot here is this knot. And I cannot understand this knot without the machine. I need the machine to be precise. But the machine cannot be artistic at all. I know that this is too big. And then the machine cannot say, this, I am too big. No, it's impossible. I can't do that. And this is a process artistic in parallel, no? And the same with Stephen Hall. Then you see Miralles, that I work a lot, and he died very, very soon, but I have worked with him a lot of times. This very small thing, these pieces of the Barcelona, all that was never built. This is the project for him to make the see that the bank says not at all. These pieces that you see here are converted of a point of view. These points of view are historical points of view in the city before. It was destroyed this place, and then the reconstruction for him is reconstruction of the points of view, and he talked with the users, with the present users, and he asked, what do you prefer here? This forms, of course, has nothing to do with the regulation or urban regulations, and has nothing to do with the historical in the sense of copy, but has a lot to do with the experience of the historical. The experience of the historical is there in the modern translation, and he knows that. Of course, the city hall says this is completely utopian because the number of housing decreases in relation to the traditional business. But it's a very good approach to an urban innovation as abstraction of the place. And then you have the same here in Zumthor Museum, that you have this picture of the destruction of the museum, the city wall, and now the simulation of the real building is made, how you have the ruins accepted by Mumford with a very clever to provoke in some kind of historical, psychological dialogue that people found very interesting, this building, just because there are the ruins in the place where the new building that has nothing to do with the old building, that you know, but you see this connection is not by chance, is not some kind of metaphysical. It's a kind of cultural relation between the past and the future a través del, through the building. And in Scarpa, the same, the Castelvetro analysis, you see here how he put people there in the building, in the design, play with the some way of the, this theater is the historical interpretation of the building. And then the people that use this building has explains that, of course, he feels and experiences some dialogue with some kind of ghost architecture in this case, but that is in the design of the Scarpa in all the building was to provoke some kind of experience of people showing them the culture of the building in his historical site. This is PhD, this building by Magda that is here in the audience, Magda Saura. It's a possibility of thousands of buildings that nobody is doing, taking the old architecture, understand the old architecture, and then to put in the new modern architecture without any problem. It's cheap, it's beautiful, and it has no technical problems at all in buildings that are for the 12th century. But these architects are scared, oh, that is no need to be scared. It's just the dialogue between history and modernity through the physical. You transparent the physical, transparent the project, and transparent the historical. You superpose design and history, and then the physical is the bridge. This is topogenesis, bridge, and the ontogenesis is the project. The sociogenesis is the history of the building. But you need to know a lot of history. This building is not any history. It's a catalog history, a very precise history, not some kind of kitsch analysis. No, real history. This is possible, and this is possible in Gaudí. Then I talk to the people in Gaudí, actually, and they say, oh, they are inventing. Of course, they are inventing, but with these ideas of Gaudí. All the maquette, the model is done to do this structure. That this structure is fractal, is mathematical, fractal, geometrically. It's a manual process of genesis of forms, fractal forms, through generating geometry. It's the geometry that generates the physical. But this can be done for anybody that listen to the ideas of Gaudí, because Gaudí says, you put this one, you do this, and you will have some kind of parabolical manifold, no? Of course, the manual person, nothing about parabolical and hyperbolical paraboloids, no. But he teach how to build this, and the people knows how to build these pieces. and understood that the species can be built with some kind of geometry that is not the traditional geometry, but at the end is a traditional architecture converted in modernity. This now is the computer. This, in this sense, is a prehistoric of topogenesis. All now can be done, all the forms can be done now by the computer and different technologies, of course. And this, Gaudí knows mathematics? No. Knows the computer? No. But could direct to fabricate these pieces. But each piece is fabricated in a very different way. When they make a paraboloid, they make some kind of string things. He explained to the worker how to do. And when the worker understands, they can build this very complicated thing that seems almost utopian. But this is possible because the geometry was not a visual geometry. Was a geometry of generating of the forms. In this sense, was a topogenetic clarissim analysis. Now they will put in the school, in the Sagrada Familia, here, the place where he was working, now will be converted in a school for students of architecture. But that the way they teach is exactly the way Gaudí teach to do the maquettes, the models, that physical models. But each piece follows a different geometrical way. All this connection that starts with circular and arrives through circular, this is fractal. Maldenbrot, they saw that, the inventor of mathematics in the fractals, saw that and he said, this is just fractal. It's not fractal without mathematics, but this is not necessary. This is geometrically fractal. He says, it's exactly my theory. And of course, Gaudí didn't know anything about this theory, but he has the concept of the generation of the forms through a geometry that is not an static geometry. It's a geometry of movement, in three-dimensional movement. Of course, it has nothing to do with the Van der Velde and all the modern avant-garde. It's another thing. It's not abstract art, but Gaudí was very interested in some aspects of abstract art, only the aspects that can be physically realized, empirically realized, if not. But the empirical synthesis of modern mathematics, Henri Poincaré, PhD dissertation, was very similar to Gaudí. The translation between real and virtual displacements did the cognitive, modern, genetic, and geometrical process. The new mathematics in the computer that are in grand part invented by Henri Poincaré, topological mathematics, he said that this is the problem. He says that, pay attention, because all the geometries are virtual and are true, but not all the geometries can be built. There are a lot of geometries cannot be built. They have not a physical translation. And then Einstein at the beginning was very angry, but at the end says, no, Henri Poincaré is right. Not all the... I guess the good mathematics to do the good geometry for the good theory of relativity that functions empirically. But this is not true in all other mathematics or geometries. They don't work. That means that it depends of the application you do in physical. This can be true or not. And this is a very, very difficult problem for artificial intelligence in architecture and very difficult problem for mathematicians. Even mathematicians are working about what really is there. Then, the concept of place, somebody talks here, the concept of place was also a bit a first definition of this possibility of mixing topogenesis and ontogenesis, because in the concept of place, the use of the place and the history of the place are completely related. And this is clear that Silver Gideon, that is used in a very different way, his generation needs to answer the link between thinking and feel by responding to the problem always the same, the relation between the inside and the outside dimensions of the human life. This is from the 63. Nobody cares that. Then they make a book in the 69 about the socio-physical structure of the history. The change in social interrelations in architecture with the new architecture. And of course, I make the foreword of this book is published in Spanish in the 75. Nobody cares. Nobody uses this. That means, and then, of course, Gideon was living two blocks, two houses in the same street of Piaget, and they were friends during 50 years. That means that Gideon, that defends Le Corbusier in a way in technology, in other way, he defends also abstract art, because the wife of Gideon was the best director of abstract art in Zurich, that this very mixon, architectural design, semiotic, I will say abstract art. Abstract art as a door to artificial dialogical formalization, not only sense science. You have some examples here. Slosky, fantastic painter, that I said, you need to read, was a professor in architecture in New York, and then the director of the Yale School of Arts, and died in Philadelphia. But these paintings now, they are sold by a million of euros. It's not very cheap, this. And then it's, of course, it's a continuation of Mondrian and all the abstract art. But then he made an explanation completely interlocutiva, and he said, this is good to explain metaphorically through time and space metaphorical, to explain, this is good because this is not, he says, this is not a strange thing. This is the solution to understand and to teach art in general. To teach art is good to make these metaphorical things. Of course, it is not the same to talk than to paint. It's not the same, but he said, when text is related to art in a metaphorical way, but this is not an enigmatic proceeding. It's the solution of the painting. This is the idea of Ricoeur. The landscape is full of my experiences of the world with noise, flowers, and colors. I paint my experience of the landscape in Europe. It's not a very strange metaphysical thing. It's just that the painting is good because there is my experience. And then the people that see this can have the experience about the color, the earth, the sun, the light, etc., in terms of humanistic painting. This is also very rejected by a lot of people. And then he sent to me the last catalog of his painting when he died some years ago. And then now I saw exhibits of Slosky that say, it's a pity that the last paintings, these paintings, is the pity that these paintings are not modern now. It's a pity. He was very modern, but now he was wrong at the end. They don't understand absolutely nothing of this critic. And he was a very good teacher of architecture, a very good teacher of painting, no? But he is completely, he was at the end. Again, this was, he said, at the beginning, I used only black and white, because it was in a virtual environment, ignore. No? The abstract art enter in and ignore things. Now I am more clever. I can paint color in this new abstract environment. This is very different. That is exactly the same that Mumford says in theory of art. The theory of art mistaken, and other examples, is Picasso works are very, very much more important than the geometry and the composition. There are a lot of other things that are lost in the process. This painting of Picasso, the Horta de San Juan in Catalonia, Gertrude Stein, when he sees that, this is Catalan culture. He says immediately, this, through the forms, Picasso is painting the Catalan form. But this was an American philanthropist that bought a lot of paintings for the lucky of Picasso and all the people and Miró. They bought this. And then now they say, no, this is a geometry, this is equilibrium of geometry. This is not equilibrium of geometry. This is much more important. This is the representation of some deep cultural thing that, with different points of view, with different three-dimensional things. It was interpretation of the whole structure in two dimensions, that is painting with the colors. This is much more important than just a game. And then I have this case, very nice case, the building of Ferraté. The abstract art is not an empty form, it's a chronotopic bridge between Antoine Henry's and the history of culture. Only men only men, imagine, and not monkeys, only men. Then this is in a house for the brother of Ferrate that is built in Horta de San Juan. No? And then it's very clear that he was inspired in Picasso. Here, more clear, impossible. it's clearly in analysis, you see the Picasso painting and you see this building immediately. And here, Horta del Ebro, que es una, is a mistake. But, and I make an article of him, I publish it out there, okay. But now he doesn't want to follow this. He's publishing a lot of books about the work of Ferrate, and this is immediately eliminated, this is danger. We don't want to see that there is an inspiration of Catalan culture. No, that is a problem. Because I am a genius, autonomous genius. I am not the work with Coderc, I am no work with Buigas or Bofill. No. I am a genius. It's a pity, because this is very interesting for students. O sigui, it's a pity that this connection is not analyzed, because it's just this connection that makes history related to design. This is a connection between history and design. It's not a geometrical thing. It's the idea of Gertrudi Stein. He's painting the Catalan culture through the urban forms. And Gertrudi Stein was not a stupid expert of art. He was a fundamental art historian in business and in ideas. That means that we are still full of prejudicial things. This is normal. There is a lot of cases and there is no problem. Then he designed this that you have here, how he, Ferrate, make the natural, it's in simulation of natural waves in Benidorm, enormous, 2 kilometers of promenade in the very high rising thing, but it's a connection between the big buildings and the good idea. Then he found that it's extremely difficult to build this because 2 kilometers of variation of forms, you cannot build a model of that at 2 kilometers. Then you need to split in pieces and to repeat the pieces. And this is the computer that it does. And the result is fairly, is not exactly of the natural, of course, but it's a very long process and making the model and then to in some way, to regularize. This is not totally natural, but it's a dialogue between the machine and the natural, very interesting case. And at the end, of course, something is there in this line and in here of the first idea of the waves, even if the first ideas are more natural, intuitive, that the other are more analytical. But this is because you cannot build a building intuitive, completely variation of 2 kilometers and to make a unique system of concrete. That's extremely expensive and very difficult. Then is the process of construction, like in Gaudí, the process of construction pushes him to use the machine, but in very controlled by the process, because he was all the time saying, no, this not, this is control. And this is the same that explained to me about the works of Gaudí. They also correct the machine all the time, like Getty. No, it's not that it's automatic. It's not automatic. There is also a criticism of the, even if it's the machine, there is a criticism. And here you see that the long dialogue between the natural and the result through the maquette, through the split lines and the maquette, and then through a problem of trying to find ways, the parts that can be repeated without eliminating the power of the artistic power. It's some kind of a game. We will see another game now. Then the digital tools and evaluation of the critical. The children can be analyzed in the spy synthesis. Of course, it's completely coherent. The situation in a dialogical city with children and their cooperation with a monological city, there is no cooperation, of course, then the city, the accessibility is the maximum when they are maximum interaction, social interaction. Here, the social interaction is out of the city, that these spaces are not social, completely antisocial. This, the machine can help, and there is no problem. Here, the machine can help to see isobis or all kind of different things, to see how a culture uses a traditional building. If an Islamic person uses a traditional building in a way that is different from a not traditional Islamic user, and then why? Because they see different things and they interpret the things in a different way in function of the behavior is not automatic of the building. The behavior depends of the main of the, if it's Islamic or not, is different. And then this can be analyzed with the machine because the machine says this person fixes the view, this person that has a different religion seems another things. That is very scientific. Because, see, the difference, the culture is not always very intuitive. No, sometimes it can be very scientific. But the machine helps, because then you see this building, for people that has not traditional views, is very difficult to be used. No? And this can be used. This is PhD philosophical dissertations by students from the School of Tunis of Architecture, the School of Architecture in Tunis. And very good, they make very good with semiotic analysis because was a French professor, Alain Renier, that was there and died there. Make a very good program. Then, Gaudí again. This is the way Gaudí see the visibility and accessibility of the Sagrada Familia. This is exactly Bill Hillier's analysis of the cities. It's the same form that he has in the cities. That means an equilibrium between accessibility and visibility, and at the end arrive to an asymmetric will. This is an asymmetric will. The asymmetric will is in London, is in Paris, in a lot of things. Very different in specific, but the model is the same. Because you need to make no direct accessibility, no direct some visibility, you need to combine. This is extremely fundamental, because the brain, like all the Freestone and Candle, Candle make an analysis, the brain accessibility uses a structure of the brain. Visibility completely different. There is no in a structure that is the same for visibility and accessibility. For that is very difficult, the Hillier spatial index, to make the analysis, because the brain has not a unique structure, because he doesn't want the brain to link visibility and accessibility 100%. Because if you do that, you are determined, but you can simulate that the brain, the human brain, has the same visibility and accessibility, the same structure in the brain. If this is true, that means that you can make the behavior changing the form. You make a change in the form, and you say sure that the behavior will be in this direction because the brain reacts, and this is completely wrong, it's not true. The brain, each brain, reacts in function of the top models that relate cultural and personal, that relates view and accessibility. And this is Gaudí the same. He was very angry with the example of Cerdà. This is very irrational. This is, you need to see a piece of the Sagrada Familia in this street, another piece of, this is completely against natural equilibrium. For him, the natural equilibrium is the same that found Hillier in the cities, that this is a combination, but this combination, each city is different because each brain is different, and then each city needs a different also. It's the same to equilibrate culturally that individual. This is very important because then the harnesses here, at the level of individual, there is critical thinking. At the level of culture, there is no critical thinking. No, this is wrong. At the level of culture, there are also critical thinking, but of course, is deposited in history and is not individual, it's social. There is a social also critical thinking. And Gaudí was very, this is not only an individual critical thinking, the social, no, this is much more complex. It will be very easy because then you make a form and then everybody uses the form in the same way because the brain is programmed. No, the brain is programmed to the double genetic things, the Langer's tree again, in a triple, it's very complicated. And now when Hillier asked to anthropologists to help him, the result is that they don't help him because they make David Simmons, if you read the models of David Simmons or the semioticians, is much more complicated than the space syntax. It's so complicated that it's no use, that it's very difficult to use the models of sociogenesis in this because it's so full of different cases. And we will see now very fast, very. Then you can analyze Barcelona and to see before the project, after the project, and course at the end. The project is the last one changes a lot the first one, because they change completely the vertical and horizontal. In reality, this has not been true. In reality, the situation now, after they don't apply the project because there's a resistance of the configuration, the city resisted to stop the horizontal lines, that's very important, not only the vertical. Then at the end, there is a solution that is natural in some way, that is not the intuitive idea of Clotet, that was very good, but was he doesn't be aware that he was cutting too much. And now the result is not applied, the project has been modified, and at the end, the result is that there are some new vertical thing that is not bad, there is new vertical thing in this case, this is new, but then the all follows that this here this was completely out of horizontal accessibility. This is wrong because we need this because there is a very important market, new market here, and the walls. This is going to very important places in the city, and the city resisted the change in this sense. But this is a very long process of years from the Olympic Games. Then some analysis of architecture of in Finlandia about accessibility and visibility. You see, the good architects, they always know that. It's not an invention. Another example is very good that Magda was working there. Mont Blanc, 12th century. Mont Blanc, 12th century, from vertical to horizontal. That is not very strange because here you have the two important doors of the wall, and now they destroy that. That is very important for Catalan kings and for Catalan culture. And now they go to Mont Blanc without the important doors and with this that is completely different of the 12th century history. Completely different. Now, they built the new all there. And this was a catastrophic discussion in the village between the different populations that were agreed to go again to this structure or other that they wanted to eliminate forever this structure. And was a strong discussion in the Academy of Arts, and Magda made a very nice discussion. It's published in the bulletin of the Academy of Arts in the Beaux-Arts. And then this make this political thing completely. And this Zumthor idea, the same, this you have here the space symptoms, that is like always very clearly mathematical director, and then the way Zumthor make this completely different, but this is very different to analyze why this for Zumthor is better than this. Of course, this is intuitive, this is analytical, but the point is
the discussion about one another. I am finishing. This is another way of the another way of other architect. Then the development of artificial intelligence, we arrive to the end. That is the thing that was before this section, how they talk about. This is still more interesting, and of course, the third branch of language theory, the computer in order to grow without killing the human life. You need to develop the topogenesis we are developing, but without killing the other two branches. And then Rainer Zimmermann, for me, one of the best theoreticians in this moment, the possible conjunction of urban studies, ergal geography and semiology, and the theory of evolutionary system on the other. Langer's tree enlarged in this way the chronotopical concepts by Bakhtin, architectonics. This is by Zimmermann, that trying to arrive to a synthesis between design and history from the artificial intelligence. It's possible, but it's extremely complex. And as we see, I have some example here. You see how this is working in digital and genetical design now. And I take one example, that is this. I met a system, the octopus articulation of accessibility and transportation simulation with nuclear radiation and winds in predicted normal configuration, Hilliard Persimmon. Of course, if this is possible, this is extraordinary advance. The thing is, you see that this is extremely difficult. This is the Kenning, Weimar, House, David Kirsch advices a clear question. Cognitive design computer role. Role of human designers within augmented design processes. This is very good. Dialogical design processes. I put a new name and a new theory. DDP. Dialogical design process. DDP. New Bauhaus, five eco places. PhD dissertation. This is extremely work. Deep learning as an optimizing octopus engine in articulation between integrated and interoperable environment. This is scanning. Bottom up with generative design environmental simulations as formative top bottom fitness objectives. That is perfect, is the whole thing. That means that this integrates neurology, history, design, creativity, everything. But you will see that this is extremely is utopian in some way. But it's nice that this is going on. I have two or three dissertations now going in this direction. One in the week, another in UPC, and the other in Valencia, and so on. In different universities. All the universities are, and this is more or less the thing that now a lot of people is. But you see 2,000 reiteration, 2 hours with octopus, and four definitive places. These definitive places are definitive chronotopic structures. Is Bakhtin in a way. It's like four words, new words in linguistic thing. This is not everything is liquid. No, something cannot be liquid, but you will see that it's very difficult. This is a piece of Vienna that is generated by the system. And then there is the problem of the bridge about the river Danubio. What is the best way to connect this? It's a problem of connection, and then you will see how they optimize. At the end, it seems that this is the best connection, but of course, each connection, the designers can take a different, this connection also has some, but they make an evaluation of that through all this. But for me, the main point is this, and this is very good by Koenig. He wants to help designers to understand what is going there, no? At the bottom, this is doing thermal comfort of streets, wind comfort of streets generated, football, foot fail, the walking through quarters, how they cross, how does the pedestrian work that we had, there are a lot of models of that. And then the access, the pedestrian from outside enter in the systems. And then, for me, the very important thing is the fitness objective. This is top-bottom. Minimize square differences from the specific target temperatures. Maximize comfortable areas and minimize dangerous areas. Maximize visitor potential and footfall through quarter. Minimize. This is just the beginning of an enormous problematic. And then you see that this is a simplification, of course, of reality, because reality of the climate is not only this or this, and reality of behavior in people in this is not only this or this. But, well, this is good to show the interest, the limitations, and the complexity of artificial intelligence. There, they arrive to this different optimization process, these four optimization process that for designers are very, well, this is, can be designed before. That means that these forms are chronotopic forms, that mean that are in some way invariants in the process, no? If you go rerunning this process, you arrive to the same solutions. That means that this is the result of optimizing a lot of different things in the way that they see it. And even if this is only four, and in some way, some kind of memory equilibrium, this is very different. When they analyze the four variables, you remember thermal, wind, this is extremely different. Even if there is an equilibrium, this equilibrium is very dissymmetric. That means that this is a very open and scientific model, no? Because even with all this, you arrive to the solution that perhaps there are other solutions that are out of the system, or perhaps these solutions are so different that all are bad, all are good. That because this is the problem now at the end of the conclusions of Kenning. And then he wants another thing that for me is the best of all that, automatic evaluation of new proposal, art and science, social dialogy. You put these horrible things here because it's very bad design, and then you see how this changes, no? But I question why you don't put a very nice and you see the solution, and this is not here. That you don't need to make this is empty. This is with some strange form. This is a change, a very old. This is like a game of, but there has no social meaning. This, that what if you put here a good Vienna example of architecture here, then what happened here? Because then this is an evaluation of the impact of this in the general model, no? But I think that now what is lacking, put a very good artistic thing here and what happened, no? Then you can begin to dialogue, because the automatic evaluation of new proposals, if these proposals are all of the same level, this level is very weak in terms of quality of urban spaces, architecture, then it's difficult to measure. But if you can put this thing that has no interest with a very interesting form here, perhaps you have a surprise that this changes a lot, and then there is a different. This is in order to interpret how this is appreciated after by the users, no? You need the rerunning, eh? And I know that I am very late. I finish. This is Architectonics, Need War, Mindland Society. There is this Congress next week. So this is for that we are full of things. Here is the next week, and then here you have the best analysis of Bauhaus, fantastic professor from Canada, and also one person that make a new history of architecture, of modern architecture, also from Canada, because in Canada they can think, it seems, more than in Europe. But in Europe, nobody dares to this. This is a very critical book of the history of modern architecture, and then they will talk by online. All that is online in Barcelona this year, and a lot of PhD students. Well, thank you. I am sorry for very long. Thank you to you. I finish.